Hi, I'm Chantal Kreviazuk.
And I'm Raine, Maida. And together we're Moon vs. Sun.
And you're watching Stingray PausePlay.
I'm Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Stingray PausePlay here in Montreal with, they're both going to roll their eyes when I say this, two Canadian music legends. Now known as Moon vs. Sun, Chantal Kreviazuk and Raine Maida. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hey, Zach.
How are you?
Great to be back here.
First question for you guys. What is the first memory that you have of each other?
I mean, literally the first time I met Chantal, we were at a concert in Toronto, and she was sitting, we were Sony Records, and we were, I guess it was a Sony box or something, and she was sitting right in front of me, or standing, and someone introduced us, and she turned around, and here we are today.
And that was that.
That was it.
Mine's so weird because the first time I saw Raine, I didn't know it was the same person when I finally met him. So I saw him at the Juno Awards the year I got my record deal with Sony Canada. And he was, this whole room was buzzing with people and I was like saying hello to Celine Dion and, you know, it was this busy night. And I looked across the room and there was a guy. Everybody else was proper and he was sitting on a booth. And I looked at him and he definitely caught my eye. But then it wasn't until I went to the Pearl Jam concert 6 months later at Maple Leaf Gardens that I was introduced to him. And I was intrigued by him in both instances.
I said I fell in love right away. She said I was intrigued.
Yeah.
Well, I was intrigued when I saw him. I didn't get to speak to him that first time. In fact, I was so intrigued by him that it was almost intimidating. Like, I didn't even, it didn't happen. I wasn't supposed to meet him that night. I might have been in love with you when I saw you. But it was when I actually engaged in conversation.
But it was enough for you to at least remember that moment. And if it was a nothing feeling, I don't think it would have even stood out.
I can remember it as clear as right now, seeing him in I think, was it Montreal or Toronto? I can't remember. But anyway, and then when I spoke to him at the concert, yeah, for me, it was the same as him. I was like, that's my guy.
You guys, you know, in the documentary, you guys really get a close shot of who you guys are as a couple. I know you guys are really all about family. What's your favorite thing to do as a family?
We spend a lot of time in the gyms with our kids. They're basketball fanatics and they all play on travel teams. So I think that seeing your child kind of thrive in that atmosphere is pretty cool. But I mean, there's so many things. I love having them at shows.
Yeah.
You know, it's really interesting. And they kind of act like they don't care. And we're not cool, which is fine.
Yeah, they have to, yeah.
But you hear them like whistling
songs
around, you know?
They get it. They care on all sorts of levels. Like Rowan will tell a story. There's a story Rowan, our oldest, told me not that long ago about how he was with his dad when they were, when he was playing an Our Lady Peace show and he overheard a conversation. And the girl was so excited and everybody was coming out on stage and it was black and then the music started and then I guess Raine came out and the girl said to her partner, I can't believe that I'm actually seeing Raine Maida live on stage. And my son welled up because he was emotional that someone was emotional about. He was piecing together that someone cares about my dad.
I was cool for like a couple days after that.
Hey, you take those days and you hold on to them as tightly as you possibly can.
But just seeing them observe that is so beautiful. Yeah.
We had the last artist that we had in to ask you guys a question. The question is from Mumford & Sons. And the question is...
Hello, we're Mumford & Sons. And our question is, what is your favorite thing about AFC Wimbledon?
So I'm going to say that it's the team's nickname.
What's the team's nickname? I'm so proud of you.
The Dons, MK Dons.
You know that for sure?
I know for sure.
That's amazing. I thought you guys weren't going to have a favorite thing and you were going to make it up.
The Dons. That's so cool.
I love it. I love that. All right, good for you guys. I'm impressed. You're now here together as Moon vs. Sun, an album, a documentary, I'm going to break your heart. Why are you guys better musically than apart?
Oh, that's a great question. I actually feel that we are better together. I mean, I have a solo artist though. I can't speak for Raine because I love Our Lady Peace. I would never put that on him. But
I don't know what band that is. I've never heard of them before.
Well, I think we're better together because we are sort of respectfully compromising one experience. So it's our life experience. It's not just mine. And what a neat way to look at a life, right?
Yeah, for me, I think it's we share so much on every other level. And being artists, it's just a very natural extension. You know, it just happens. I mean, it's not, I wouldn't say it's easy, because nothing is easy in life. But it's very natural, if that makes sense.
Yeah, definitely. You know, you guys have been together for 22 years, something like that. You've been trying to make this album for 6 years, 7 years, 8 years. Why was now, or I guess then, the time to say, let's just lock ourselves down for 2 weeks and not do it, or versus 2 years before that or 3 years later?
You kind of just have to commit at some point. And I think we were really, really wanting to...
Yeah, but we had to force ourselves because we wrote a song called A Love Woman Make Me Beg a long time ago, probably 5 or 6 years ago. And like... It's one of those magical moments that I can look back on, like my musical career, when we walked into the studio late at night and this song just kind of poured out, and you just got a feeling like this is really interesting and special. And because of that, we just felt, okay, it'll naturally, over the next couple months, we'll just do this a few more times and then we'll have some music and we can go out and play it.
And then 4 years
put it out
now.
Yeah, 4 or 5 years goes by, nothing. Like literally, not another song.
Yeah, right.
By the virtue of hiring people to say, we're going to film this, booking hotels and flights to go to St. Pierre and Miquelon, was like, okay, now we have other responsibilities for people that we can't just at the last minute cancel. And it worked.
It worked out beautifully because the album is so stunning.
Oh, thank you.
As you guys say, you know, it's, you can feel that visceral sense of the songs. They're real. They're so authentic. Even the production, you know, it's very minimal. It's very transparent. And I think that really speaks to the vibe of the whole project. Mm. What was the song that was hardest to complete from start to finish?
Well, the end title, it's funny. I was asleep. I always sleep in the studio. I shut down when I'm creative. I just all of a sudden go gunk. So it's nice when we're at home because I can just fall asleep.
I think there's ghosts that do that too. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I'm so funny. I literally shut down. So... I was asleep on the couch and Raine was working and he had written this beautiful thing and it woke me up. And it was, you know, in this low line, I can see. It was very pretty. And I had this sort of like image in my head of, oh, wouldn't it be neat if all of a sudden there was just like this really joyful thing that bookended this. And I popped up and I said, turn the mic on. And I sang the, ooh, ooh, the chanting part thing. And so that was done. But then it kind of went away and we weren't even sure we were going to use it. And it just kept resurfacing. So the rest of the songs came together actually pretty easily, lyrically and melodically. But that one just kind of was discombobulated.
I mean, in the film, you see the typical dynamic of writing and that process. And it doesn't always go well, but it's like at the end of the day, these songs weren't, we weren't making Born to Run. Like it happened really quickly, you know, which is, When I look back on it, we basically made an album in 10 days.
Well, yeah, and you're not divorced, and the music is
and
great.
And we're together, and we're sitting here.
So I think really those two things are so important.
See, that's a man's perspective. You got the songs, you didn't end up divorced, everything's fine.
In the end, it's like all those problems existed, and you talk through them, and you work through them, and then,
gosh.
It's a process, right? It's a day-by-day thing, and as I believe you guys said in the movie, it's not about perfection, it's about the process.
I said that,
And I think that's a really important mentality to hold in these kinds of relationships. So the movie is obviously so relatable with you guys as a couple and kind of seeing into that world. You know, the biggest fights that I have with my wife are over a look or a tone. Like, that's it. It's not
100%.
Money. It's not kids. It's like, why'd you have to look at me that way? Or how come you said that way and you couldn't have said that nicer? And you guys speak volumes in your artist name. It's not Moon and Sun.
No,
right?
It's
Moon versus Sun.
Yeah.
And that's a big thing. So what's the best piece of advice for you guys as someone for just trying to keep their shit together and find joyful moments with their partner?
I think stop. The whole idea.
Well, what is Dr. Johnson?
It's CPR. Pause. It's catch, pause, repair. So I think we're getting better at, you know, first of all, catch. You even catch yourself like, oh my gosh, we have just gone from 0 to 100 and just talked about like separating assets and all we were talking about was milk in the fridge earlier.
But there's a point moving there. I think that it should really be like catch.
Yeah.
Admit that you caught it.
Yeah.
You know?
Well,
cuz I'm sure like I catch things
catch.
And I'm like, I'm not going to say.
Well, it's funny in the film there's a point someone played it yesterday in an interview, and it's when I say I don't think I call you stupid, but I said that.
You said that idea is that, stupid. Yeah.
Right. And up until like 2 months ago, I still swore to God I never said
and
it.
We've
you know,
been in
even
the
in the moment, you were pretty
year.
Sure.
I know.
Yeah.
I know.
I'm like, oh, I can
you right, yeah, yeah. Right. You had the recording right there.
It happened again, actually, in an interview recently. I won't get into the details, but afterward, I said, well, why did you say that? Because her question was blah, blah, blah. And he said, that wasn't her question. So I wrote the journalist. And I, was like, I just want to clarify, because it was more for me. I'm not Claire from
Modern
Family.
It was not for you.
From
Chantal,
Modern
Chantal
Family.
Chantal,
I didn't need to be
that
right.
Was Chantal for likes catch, pause, prepare,
write the journalist.
Remind you, yeah.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
No, it was
you
more
really,
I wanted
you
to.
You emailed the journalist?
I did, because
yes.
I wanted yeah, to know exactly. If I was crazy. And no. Or not.
Okay, but
yeah.
No matter what happened in the interview, that's not the crazy part.
What's the crazy part? That I wrote the journalist?
I would say writing the journalist.
Thank
no,
you.
For no, me. No, because you don't know what the question was.
Well, then tell me what it is. I can't wait.
The question was, what's like your favorite thing you've discovered about your wife and your
Raine?
Partner? And I answered the question.
Yeah,
and then I had this beautiful, I said this beautiful thing about my husband, and then I'm like, it's Raine's turn, and I'm not expecting like roses and like, you know, petals to fall out of the air, but like something, right? He answered an entirely different question. I was like, this is my life. So the journalist and I had a little chuckle, and she said, don't worry about it.
Yeah.
And then after he was certain, but I think it's an ears thing. Like when you start talking about the science of boys, men, hearing, all that stuff, it's very different. I mean, mm-hmm. The reality is women, this is my, I might get murdered for saying this, but it really is about picking moments and picking battles. And the reason is that we're not the same. Our brains are not the same. We don't even hear the same. And so, I don't know, I've learned, I mean, Raine and I have been together almost 23 years, and I just feel like some conversations are just better for me and my mom or me and my girlfriends, and he doesn't need to like.
And I think there's an art to answering questions, and it's very subjective, like music.
But you actually believed, by the way, that the question was a different question. You didn't.
And I wrote her back a different answer.
I know
so there you
did.
Go.
I know you did, and that was beautiful.
Yeah.
But anyway, I just think that we don't even hear the same.
Agreed.
Yeah.
But I mean, look, you're together.
We keep going back to that for now.
But you find,
after this
you know,
interview.
I think that it's not about finding real, genuine happiness every day. It's about a life together. And, you know, it's you're together and you make beautiful music together. Will there be a second album?
This is like evidence of life for this project now for us. So it's now every time we have an idea or something. I think it's going to be easier to finish it and really dig into it because we know that we have like a platform.
And I just think what'll be really neat is continuing to discover what Moon versus Sun is as a musical act and watching it develop and grow.
It's really nice feeling new as an artist again. Like that's kind of cool.
Right.
It's really interesting.
No one's expecting a Chantal Kreviazuk song. No one's expecting an Our Lady Peace rock anthem. It's you can be whatever you want to be, and that must be a nice feeling
it
after
is.
Being
it's
in the music
amazing.
Business for so long.
Outside of the kids and outside of the regular things we have to team up on, it's nice to have something that, you know, it's new for Raine and I at the same level and pace, and I think that's a great message as well.
And musically, we're still, like we are still, even though we filmed the documentary of the process of the songs, we have an album done, we're still kind of figuring out. That's really interesting to me, the fact that we did this whole album, but I don't think we've really, it's kind of like the tip of the iceberg. So that's exciting, as artists anyway. And as artists, I think the live show is so different from anything that I've ever done because of that. Because we'll go on stage in a huge fight and bring that into the music and on stage and talk about it and kind of like get through it on stage. And I just find like it's such a...
Who needs Dr. John? Yeah.
Yeah, it's such a creative outlet in that way. And for whatever reason, people kind of dig it. So
I love
it's healing. It's very
it's healing. Yeah. Yeah, our shows are healing.
Yeah.
as an artist and a fan of music, I would, you know, I would love to see some of the nitty gritty behind some of the great songs that I, you know, listen to.
Well, guys, I mean, I'm so happy the album turned out. The documentary is beautiful. I'm just such a fan of you guys. Thank you so much for sitting down and just kind of being open about so many things with me. I really, really appreciate it.
Of course. Thank
I really
you very
do.
Much.
Thank you.
You can hear Moon vs. Sun on Stingray's Pop Adult channel, Adult Alternative channels, And if that's not enough for you, jump on our web player and our mobile app, find the little magnifying glass search icon, type in Raine Maida, Chantal Kreviazuk. You're allowed to Google how to spell that. It's totally okay. Or Our Lady
Peace. It's very phonetic, I promise.
It is. And you can hear the combined 86 channels that we play their music on. We'll see you guys next time.